Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this NFC matchup between the Carolina Panthers and the San Francisco 49ers. Up here in the booth, we can barely see the field.
Well, that might be good for me. Maybe I'll finally call something right. But just kidding, it's going to be tough out there today. It's going to be not about the plays you make. It's going to be about not turning the football over.
ers setting up for the kickoff. He will run this one back.
Well, that time the kick returner just does an awful job. He doesn't read the blocks. His guys are knocking him down. He goes the wrong way, and that gives him bad field position.
The quarterback's hollering out instructions. Nickel formation for the defense here. Just a quick drop back.
I got to blame the offensive line that time. Giving up a sack early in a game like that, you cannot take chances. Don't overplay as an offensive lineman. If you do it, you give up a sack.
Second and 13. The quarterback throws to the right.
You got to be smart on the defensive side now here, third and long. Be a little careful. Maybe give up a short pass or a short run. And if they throw it short, make sure you come up and make the tackle.
Come on now. Wake up. Now looking at third down. Three-step drop. That's a conversion, the first of the day. Give him a new set of downs.
Nice job by the offense picking up that first down here to start the game, and that is important to give you a little confidence, to give you some rhythm, and most of all, just release some of that pressure you feel.
First and 10, D'Angelo Williams. Nifty move past the defender. That's a gain of 6.
Good job that time by the offense. Power run gets him a few yards.
What is it about Newton that makes him so special?
Well, let's see. What makes Cam Newton special? He's big, strong, fast, and he can throw it down the field, and he's accurate. I think the question is, what is it about
the pigskins on the ground?
Well, the one thing we know about the NFL, when you have the football in your hands, they are going to attack it. You've got to know that as a ball carrier, protect it a lot better.
It's a two tight end formation. First down and 10. Frank Gore gets it here. They break through. Tackled him behind the line. Loss of 4 on the play. It's now second down. Knocked him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, when you get in situations like this, third long, you got to be smart on the offensive side. Yeah, I know you want to pick up the first down, but don't force it, because if you do, it'll probably lead to a turnover.
There's the quarterback barking out new signals.
Jim, look at that. The defensive line now shifting to the right.
Play action. Quarterback has it on his hip. Now looking to throw.
Quarterback made a big mistake that time. Don't carry out the play action fake when you know you're under pressure. He tries to do it. It results in a sack.
Not sure why they're going to go for it at this point, but they are. They're not going to punt. 49ers turn the ball over on down.
You are not going to be an accurate quarterback, of course, when you're under this kind of pressure. Doesn't even have time to set his feet. Another throw offline.
Offense now in the red zone. reaches in, swats it away.
This defense can pressure the quarterback. There's no doubt about it. They did this time, and it results in another incompletion.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. And now they'll try over again on second down. This is a five-step drop back. Throws it in the end zone. Touchdown.
That was a sweet touchdown right there. Just a nice throw by the quarterback. He put it right on the money. The receiver makes the catch. Beautiful touchdown.
Inside of the upright.
Offside defense.
Players from both sides making an appeal, but the officials saw it on the defense. Well, this works out about 40% of the time. So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure two extra points. Panthers ready to get the pigskin in the air. He's got a chance to return this one.
What a good job by the kickoff team. The ball's kicked high in the air, and they sprint all the way down there. The blockers can't get set up. Nice tackle. Now they got great field position for the defense.
Offense lines up here. Now first and 10. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Hey, baby, this ain't good enough. Watch out for you.
Coming up, second down.
Let's go! Grand 38! Grand 38!
Flex round! Flex round!
Ohio!
Flex round! Flex round!
The quarterback mixing things up at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 13. That's an interception. Tackles made.
What a terrible job by the quarterback. Nobody's open. Tries to force the pass, and look, what's it turn into? An interception.
Wake up!
Double tight end formation. Looking for an open. The ball is out.
That was just a terrible job by the offensive player that time. Protect the football. No excuse for letting it fumble the football in a situation like that.
The 49ers ready to take over the football. Getting a look at the Wildcat here. First and 10, Gore to the right. Tackled down at the 22.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second down now. Right back to him one more time. They tackle him for a loss.
Loss of two on the play.
On the way, third down. And he's taken down.
Nice job that time by the outside linebacker getting the sack. They ask a lot of these guys now. They are special players in the NFL. Stopping the run and the speed to get outside and get the sacks on the quarterback, too.
Ohio!
Got a flag on the field. Looking to the right side and throwing. Makes the play.
Outside defense.
He'll decline the penalty and let the play stand. able to move the chains after that penalty.
Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. After a 5-yard gain.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
Second down here.
Slips past one player.
The quarterback has his team's attention here.
Third and 9. The throw to the left. Swatted away.
Well, the best thing you can say on the offensive side that time is the quarterback got rid of the football. Terrible protection. Nowhere to throw it. Just throw it away.
Play clock's running down. That's going to be a timeout charged to the offense. Heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Touchdown. This game is tight.
Well, that is something to watch, isn't it? A Hail Mary pass that goes for a touchdown. You think, there is no chance this is going to work. But every once in a while, you get lucky. That's what the offensive did. They got lucky, and they get the touchdown.
He made it.
15 minutes down, 45 minutes to go. And we'll return after this message and a word from your local station.
They line up here for the onside kick. They want that football back. The onside kick executed to near perfection, and it looks like the kicking team has it. Panthers getting set now for their next series.
Good job here by the quarterback. He doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
And the ref has thrown a flag. There's a player down on the field. Trainers on their way out.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
It's first down as they head to the line.
Challenges the coverage. It has the completion.
Well, I guess the best thing to say there, Jim, is they completed the pass, but it still did not get a first down.
Offense lines up here. Second and 1. Looking across the middle. No one was open.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football. And it leads to another incomplete pass.
Some good news on the injury.
It does not appear to be as serious as we first thought, and he is expected to get back into this game.
Yeah, he's going to come back in. I mean, that's good news for him. I don't know if the team's too happy about it because he's playing awful. But, you know, if he gets back out there, maybe he can change things around.
Defenses are so aggressive in these situations now. A lot of coaches don't want to turn around and hand the ball off to somebody that's 6 or 7 yards deep. Use your quarterback, run that quarterback sneak, and a good job picking up the first down.
Good job getting the first down by the offense. And look at the defensive players on the sideline cheering their teammates on. Keep us on the sideline a little longer. That's what they're hoping for.
The offense coming to the line inside the opponent's 20. Knocked away incomplete.
And what you do in man-to-man defense sometimes, get up there and disrupt the wide receiver. Disrupt his rhythm, disrupt the timing, and what do you get? Another incompletion.
The quarterback's calling something out. Second down coming up. Trying to work the middle of the field. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down and he's in pain.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field, and my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. 5-step drop. He's looking to the right. What a catch. Touchdown.
Tight ends are so valuable down on the goal line. They're able to maneuver inside. Easy to get defenders to run into each other to get open to score.
We saw an injury early in this game, and now we're starting to hear he should be able to return before this one's over. So that's some good news.
Yeah, it is good news to him, his family, all the friends, and, of course, the fans here in attendance today. They're going to be happy because he has been playing awfully well.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this two. And so they convert it here on the two-point try. The kicking team now getting set here for what looks like an onside kick. Team has the recovery. First down here. Obvious running play here out of the strong eye. And he's pushed out of bounds.
With the carry, gain of 6.
Ohio! Ohio!
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of. Look at the hand signals he's given to the receiver outside.
Second down and 4. Quarterback drops back, play action. That ball is picked off. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
Well, the protection was bad. Quarterback didn't have the time. He's off balance, and he throws the incompletion. Now, about that injury we saw earlier in this game, I'm happy to report it looks like he will be getting back into action today.
Yeah, it's good news that he's coming back into this game. I think the big question is, you and I will watch it, we'll see if he's still the same player once he comes back in.
Second down following that incompletion from the shotgun. He'll fire it out to the left.
and he's intercepted. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
Good job that time by the defense, not being fooled, being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
First down on the way. A tackle behind the line.
1 yard loss on the play.
Split backfield here. There's some shifting around in the backfield. Second and 11. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
Loss of two.
Third down following the run. The quarterback's hollering out instructions. Looking long. That ball was going the other way. He stacked up at that point.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
Offense lines up here. First and 10. And he wants to throw it across the middle. That tackle was made at the 27-yard line.
You do not have to be as accurate as a quarterback when you're throwing against zone defenses. There's nobody close to knock it down. So that time, not a great throw, but because it was his own defense, he still gets the completion.
Interception. He's got some daylight. Touchdown and drawing close.
You talking about getting your team full of emotion and getting everything on your side. How about that interception by the defense and then taking it back all the way for the score?
Getting set now to attempt the extra point. And the point effort is good. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation. That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. They bring in an extra defensive back.
Honey, wake up. Do something.
Honey, first down and 10. The quarterback throws it on the mark.
There's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a receiver like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, the double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up, and make the catch.
There's the quarterback barking out new signals. Second and 2. Getting away from the pressure. And the tackle is made at the 35-yard line. Look at that whole cadre of receivers on one side.
Wake up. On the ball, on the ball, on the ball, on the ball. Here we go.
Run it up. Quick drop back. Secures it with two hands. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
from inside the red zone, so dangerous.
Come on now.
The quarterback mixing things up at the line of scrimmage. And now on first down, we'll go back to the air. Brings it in for the score in the end zone.
Well, Jim, it's almost impossible to guard these guys nowadays as they go down the field. These wide receivers, they have feet like ballerinas. And even though you get tight coverage, they're so quick, they can get open and make the catches.
The Panthers for the extra point. The flag is out. Add the extra point. The kick is good. Looks like the defender was caught in the neutral zone, Phil.
Yeah, he was. Good job by the quarterback. You know, he made that little voice inflection. That'll get him every time. Quarterback's a little sneaky, you know.
The defense showing blitz. Lining up now for the two-point conversion. Put an additional 2 points on the board as they convert. They're lining up for the onside kick. They want to get the ball back. The onside kick's going to pay off here. Kicking team appears to have the ball. The defense comes out in the nickel. Now first and 10. He'll throw it over the middle. Makes the catch. That brings the play to an end.
Hard to play man-to-man coverage all the time in the NFL. That time we see the man-to-man coverage, the quarterback sees it. Nice throw.
And we've reached the two-minute warning in this one. First down here after the completion.
On the ball, on the ball, on the ball, on the ball.
D'Angelo Williams. Fumble.
One thing coaches hate when their offense is on the field is fumbling the football. Because a lot of times it's just bad fundamentals. But they're lucky this time they have the fumble. They're able to get on top of it.
The quarterback has his team's attention here. Dropping back three. Great coverage there on that pass attempt.
Nice job that time by the defense. Pressure on the quarterback. He does not have time to find an open guy, and it results in an incompletion.
From inside the red zone.
Here we go. Come on now. Wake up.
Good job here by the quarterback. He doesn't like what he sees on the defense.
Ball's picked off. Nice tackle.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football. The results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. First and 10. And the give to Frank Gore. They pounce on him there.
When you see a long run like that, you know what it does? It just breaks the will of the defense. In the NFL, that's all about passing. We see all these wonderful things. But when it comes down to it, who can win the war up front? And you win the war
by running the football. Great job by the offensive line that time.
The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time.
Quarterback's got to know when it's inside of 2 minutes and that clock is moving. You want to get the football down the field and out of bounds. Holds on to the football too long, gets the sack, and that just kills the time management.
The quarterback's calling something out.
He'll fire it out to the left. And it's off the mark.
Good job of getting open deep down the field. The quarterback cannot make the throw. Sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of. Look at the hand signals he's given to the receiver outside.
Under fire on that throw.
Terrible job by the offensive line. Your quarterback needs more time than that. Another incompletion.
Should be a routine punt.
Set up return. Here he goes. And he's going to give his team great starting field position on that return. They come to the line of scrimmage and an excellent starting point. Looking down the field. A takeaway. Breaks free, has some space to work with. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, that's a good sight for all the fans to see. He gets up and walks off the field, and I think he's going to be okay. He's just going to need a couple minutes to catch his breath, and we'll see him back on the field, it looks like, shortly.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
Eyeing that left side. Reaches out and grabs it. And that's a gain of 9.
Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than 7, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
That leads us to second down.
Frank Gore gets it here. Touchdown. And this game just got a whole lot more interesting.
Good job by the offensive coordinator calling those plays. Leads to a touchdown. They're just slowly chipping away at this lead. Now can the defense come out and help them out?
We've got an update on the earlier injury, and we're hearing now he will return to the field. So thankfully, the injury was not all that serious.
Yeah, it's good news to hear, isn't it? I mean, for his family, his friends, and of course, most importantly right now for the football team, they need him back out there.
The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff. They'll take it at the 20. Panthers are getting set for their next possession. This will most likely be the final play before the half ends. The quarterback's hollering out instructions. Takes the snap from the shotgun. Wide open for the catch. Gains 20.
That's a nice job by the offense there. Get the first down, keep those chains moving, give yourself three more opportunities.
So that's going to do it for the first half. Panthers are up in this one. We're back here now in this one where the Panthers lead by three.
Bill, we've got a good one going on here. How about breaking it down?
Well, they go in at halftime, they got a lead, and I'll tell you what, the confidence has to be high. That confidence to give the coach a positive reinforcement so he can call those plays in the second half to give his team the best chance to win. And you know what? I think the can's going to be fun to watch here in the second half.
Good piece of tackling. The 49ers come onto the field for their next series.
Flex round! Flex round!
First down, offense readying for the snap. Eye formation and a handoff.
When you're an offensive lineman and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards, you are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying, we're tougher than you are and we're just going to come right at you.
Second and six. Staying on the ground. And he's going to be tackled right around the 37, wasting little time.
That was a running play that time by the offense. It picked up some good yards. Nothing like it. Show the defense you're willing to get in there and slug it out and get some tough running yards.
Staying on the ground. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Well, it's about deceiving the defense, isn't it? That's how you get a lot done in the NFL. And when you can run and pass, you can deceive them in a lot of ways. Nice job by the offense, running that football, picking up another first down and moving the chains.
Offense lines up here. First and 10. He gets it again on this drive. He'll go left. Knocked out of bounds.
A lot of ways to get plays in the NFL. It doesn't always have to be by a pass. Good job that time by the running back.
First down here after the run. Gets it again here. Going to lose yards here.
Loss of three.
And here we have second down. Steps back to throw. Has the reception all alone. He steps out.
You know, sometimes you got to call some passes that actually go down the field. You keep throwing it short. The defense knows you're going to do it. They come up and make the tackle for a short gain.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Third down and 11. Going to be a tackle for a loss.
The ball carrier on the play. 3 yard loss on the play.
the 49ers in field goal formation. And converts on the three.
This guy is a threat anytime you cross midfield. Really, he can kick it from 60 yards. Great leg strength. What a weapon to have on your side.
49ers setting up for the kickoff. Now the smart play here is just a squib. The ball is jarred loose. The tackle is made.
Well, that's nothing but just that's just luck. That's all you can say. The return team, they fumble the football, it bounces out, and they get it back. They lucky there.
On the ball, on the ball, on the ball, on the ball.
There's the quarterback barking out new signals. They face first down. Three-step drop. He has the grab. Touchdown.
Wide receivers, they have turned into stars in the NFL. You know why? Because they can make catches like this. What a great catch.
The Panthers for the extra point. Good. And following the extra point, the Panthers are leading by 7. The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Setting up return. Hold on a minute. There's an injured player on the field.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
The 49ers come onto the field now for this next series. First down here.
Ohio! Ohio! Flex round! Flex round! Ohio! Ohio!
The quarterback throws to the right. The defense had that one covered.
Well, the quarterback can't get him open. He threw to the right guy that time, but the coverage was so good by the defense, nowhere to get the completion.
Nobody but the quarterback in the backfield here. From the gun. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Ball spotted away.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
The quarterback mixing things up at the line of scrimmage. They face third down after the incomplete pass.
Ball's thrown, incomplete. Great coverage there by the defense.
There's a difference. When you play zone, you drop back and you watch the quarterback and you react to the football. When you're playing man-to-man, all you're worried about is where that receiver goes. You try to shadow him, look for the football.
ball and try to make a play. About this, they're trying to pick up the first down on fourth down, forgetting the punt.
He brings it in. For so many years, we had all these rinky-dink, dink and dunk quarterbacks. Now we got guys in there throwing it deep down the field. What a nice catch. What a really good deep throw.
Let's see how they back up the big play here.
First down and 10. Takes it from the strong eye.
Time for the no-huddle offense.
It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush.
Well, I know it's not going to make a highlight film, but still a good solid run-up in there for a couple yards.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. Third and 6.
Back to the running back.
He's headed right. The tackle was made short of the first, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Four on the play.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive.
Flex round! Ohio! Ohio!
They'll run it with him again.
Ooh, they failed to pick up the first, and the ball will go back to the other side.
When you decide to go for it on fourth down as a head coach, you got to realize you're going to be one of two things. You're going to be a genius or an idiot. And if you don't make it, look out. The second guessing begins.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Zeroed in on that one. Touchdown, Panthers.
What a good job by the wide receiver. Not a terrific pass, but he just goes in there, makes a wonderful catch for the touchdown.
The Panthers for the extra point.
Makes the PAT.
They're lining up here for the onside kick. The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. Niners getting ready now to start their drive. Two tights for this play. Now first and 10. Launching it deep.
under pressure and incomplete.
That was an excellent job by the offensive coordinator. He called the right play. Good route by the wide receiver. Wide open down the field. Just a terrible throw by the quarterback, missing the big completion.
The quarterback has his team's attention here.
The quarterback throws the pass. No way that would be completed.
Well, you want to put all the pressure on the quarterback to make really good throws down the field. Play tight man-to-man coverage. It takes perfect throws to get completions. Not there that time.
Here, a split backfield.
They'll just spike it right here.
No, wait. It's a fake spike, and they're going to throw.
Good job by the receiver that time. Getting that extra couple yards, gets a first down. They are marching. Let's see how the defense reacts.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play.
Going across the middle, airtight coverage, incomplete.
Nice job by the quarterback that time. Got outside the pocket, got away from the pressure. Gave himself time, even though the pass is incomplete. Good job of avoiding the sack.
Ohio! Ohio!
Split backfield here.
The formation here, shotgun.
Looks to his left. Sticks to his hands.
They tackle him at the 26-yard line.
No time to huddle now.
Well, it's a nice throw and catch by the quarterback and receiver. Puts them in good position where they have a chance to pick up this third down.
Look at the defensive linemen talking. They're all now shifting to the left.
And he hauls it in.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than seven, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
15 minutes to go, and we'll return after this message and a word from your local station.
Welcome back, folks. We're getting set for the start of the next quarter.
Some good news on the injury. It does not appear to be as serious as we first thought, and he is expected to get back into this game.
Yeah, he's going to come back in. I mean, that's good news for him. I don't know if the team's too happy about it because he's playing awful. But, you know, if he gets back out there, maybe he can change things around.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Looking across the middle.
Well, even though they're down more than seven here, the offense down the red zone, it'll be good for them for the rest of this game. Their confidence. For the offensive coach, if they could punch this in for the touchdown.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Quarterback sneak. And that gains one.
Really important they find a way to score in this drive here. So close to the goal line, they got to get back in this game. And if they find a way to score, even though they'll still be behind, it'll give them a lot of confidence.
This will be the eighth play of this drive. Will run, touchdown. That'll close the gap.
Well, it's a nice touchdown drive by the offense. They're still behind, but I gotta say this to the defense. You're just giving up. You're letting them march down there and letting them get back in the game. Toughen up and get it done.
The 49ers for the extra point. And the extra point is good. It's getting late in this one. The Panthers are leading by seven. line up here for the onside kick. They want that football back. The 49ers get ready to start their drive. Looks like they're going to run a little wildcat here. First and 10, Gore. Running to the right. They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. From the gun. Trying to work the middle of the field. Makes the catch. Deep to San Francisco. Touchdown.
Well, that score ties the game up. Now on the defensive side, you've got to come out there and take advantage of this feeling you got going now and get the football back for your offense.
The point after try is in the books. The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff. This kick will stay on the ground, avoiding a big return. Nickel formation here for the defense.
Come on now.
Good job here by the quarterback. He doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals. When you play zone coverage, the quarterback might have to hold the football just a little longer, but these guys nowadays, when you play zone, they know how to throw and catch and get it done.
Wake up.
First down coming up. The quarterback's calling something out.
Come on now. Here we
go. Looking to go up top again on first down. Just had to avoid the sack. Incomplete.
Play doesn't even have time to develop. The quarterback is under so much pressure, he's throwing it before these receivers are even ready. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of. Look at the hand signals he's given to the receiver outside.
Second down and 10. Working that left side. He makes the catch.
Well, that's a nice completion by the offense. And what it does, it just puts them in a more manageable situation so they can pick up that third down.
Offense lines up here.
On the ball.
The quarterback's hollering out instructions. Third and 5. Taking off. The t- tackle was made, but the first down is picked up. They load up one side with a whole flock of receivers. There's the quarterback barking out new signals. Back to the air here on first down. Makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown.
Nice throw by the quarterback that time. Put it right on the money. Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today. Great control of the football. Put it right in there for the touchdown.
There's a yellow marker down on the field. The point after is good. He was trying to get an early jump on the play, but the referee caught him in the neutral zone. They're going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. The kicking team now getting set here for what looks like an onside kick. It looks like they've recovered the onside kick. If they're going to have any chance at all here late in the fourth, the defense must make a big stop and give the ball back to the offense. First and 10. Trying to find an open man. That's a tackle right near the 48.
7-yard gain on the play.
Well, as the clock is winding down, the offense would like to just run it out. The quarterback mixing things up at the line of scrimmage. Just a quick drop back. And he wants to throw it across the middle. Finds the sacred sod. Touchdown.
It's commonplace now. It's hard to even say the word great for a catch by the wide receiver. We see so many of them. But this one, that is a great catch.
Extra point is good. Time's becoming a factor in this one as the Panthers lead by 13. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation. Receiving team has the recovery.
Ohio! Ohio!
Great starting position here for the offense. It's the old Marino play, a fake spike, and looking to throw. No separation at all. Incomplete.
I think that's the hardest pass a defensive back has to defend. The long throws down the field. You have to wait till the last second to make your play. That time the defensive back did it. What a play.
Time enough to squeeze in one more play before the two-minute warning here in the fourth. Snap back to the quarterback. That ball has been picked off. He's brought down.
I have to say that's just a terrible decision by the quarterback there. He's got to know. When you're in a situation like this, you just cannot make that type of pass.
These DBs will not back off.
On the ball.
They come to the line, and it's first down.
Wake up.
Three-step drop. Airing it out. He caught it. Gets past the first wave. End zone bound, and he's got the touchdown.
Now we're talking about some of the fastest humans on earth. And we take into account you can't touch them or breathe on them. That's how they're able to get open and make so many catches.
Count it. They're lining up for the onside kick. They want to get the ball back. That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. First down as they head to the line. They'll go shotgun here. He'll throw it over the middle. With two hands, he has it.
Well, that's the way to stand in there for the quarterback. He knows he's going to take the hit. He still throws the football down the field and gets the completion. Let's put it this way. If you can't do that as a quarterback, you won't be playing in this league.
First down here, out of the shotgun formation. Staying with them stride for stride, and the pass is incomplete.
That's what you have to do as a defensive back. You got to wait till the last second. Wait till the receiver uses his hands. And once they go up, put your hand in between them and knock that football down. What a play.
This will be second down. Drop back, shotgun formation, looking to the right side and throwing. No room to complete that one.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Completion. It sets up third and 10. It's a spike. No, it's a fake. The quarterback throws the pass.
That was excellent man-to-man coverage at time. When you want to shut down a receiver, really the only way to do it is to man up and play him one-on-one.
Offense back on the field here for this 4th and 10 play. Out of the gun. Going across the middle, and they'll turn it over on downs. The defense does a fantastic job holding strong. The Panthers ready to take over the football.
Wake up.
The quarterback has his team's attention here.
On the ball.
First down and 10. Running away from the sack. The defense gets the sack.
This quarterback has shown us he can do everything. Good in pass coverage down the field. Physical at the point of attack. Can tackle running backs when they come out there. And how about that blitz that time? Good timing, and gets the sack on the quarterback.
Wake up! Come on now.
Good job here by the quarterback. He doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing
the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Quick drop back. Trying to work that left side. Ball is batted down.
Got to give the secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
The pass play fails to work, and now it's third down.
The defense did not give up an inch.
Incompletion by the quarterback that time. It was good, tight, man-to-man coverage.
The coach is going to go for it. The quarterback's calling something out.
Quarterback taking the snap from the shotgun.
Well, it's all about timing when you're talking about a quarterback and receiver. They both got to be on the same page, know what each one is expecting from the other. That time it was not there. That's why we have another incompletion.
Winning the field position battle right here as they start the next drive. Now first and 10. And the give to Frank Gore.
Well, Jim, that's a tough play call right there. Running the football when you're down multiple scores here late in the game. You only pick up a couple yards. I don't think you can afford to make those kind of decisions.
Second down and 9. The defense gets a sack.
You know, when you get sacked like that, it just comes down to the quarterback. You hate to put all the pressure on him, but you have to know it. In this league, the rules, you can throw it away, so no use holding on to that football and taking those hits, and most importantly, and losing those yards and putting your team in a tough position.
And coming up next is the post-game wrap-up, brought to you by Gatorade, G-Series Recovery.
Hey everybody, Trey Wingo here. I want to welcome you to Madden NFL.